वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
हाँ गुड मॉर्निंग सर. एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू?
यस मैम, बट इट्स वेरी स्लो. इट मीन्स वॉइस इज वेरी नॉट क्लियर. हेलो.
हेलो.
यस मैम, यस मैम, नाउ इट्स ऑडिबल.
इट्स ऑडिबल ना क्लेमेंट सर?
क्लेमेंट सर वॉइस इज म्यूट. म्यूट म्यूट सर, मे बी म्यूट.
या या, ही इज म्यूटेड. क्लेमेंट सर,
can you hear me ma'am?
Good morning sir.
Sir, can you hear now?
Yes, yes sir, yes sir, sure sir.
Yes sir, we can start the session. Surendra sir.
Yeah ma'am, yeah, we will start.
Okay,
the time is there.
Yeah
madam, just 1 minute.
Okay sir. Okay,
okay, okay sir,
just 1 minute. Can you hear now?
Yes sir, yes sir, sure.
Yes sir,
I can start sir.
Good morning, yes sir, sir, you can start sir. Good morning,
yes
sir.
Yes. Okay, good morning everyone. On behalf of the Nursing Teacher Association of India, I Suren Sharma, associate professor, Amity College of Nursing, and Haryana State Treasurer of the Nursing Teacher Association of India, would like to welcome all of you, those who are joined today's session and today's webinar session. I would welcome you, all of you, for this webinar series on nursing theory and their application that started from 25th July. Our today topic is Ernst Wiedenbeck, Einstein Wiedenbeck, The Helping Art of Clinical Nursing, and Rosemary Rizzo Parse, Human Becoming Theory. Now, I would like to introduce our today's speaker, Dr. I. Clement sir. Sir currently working as a principal and professor in the Department of Medical Surgical Nursing at Columbia College of Nursing, Bangalore. He has obtained doctorate in nursing from Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education, Chennai, post-graduation from the Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University, Chennai, and he has experience of more than 16 years after post-graduation. He has very long professional journey from auxiliary nurse to the doctorate in nursing. So, sir, have nearby 34 years of experience in nursing. Sir completed many other degree courses as MBA in education from the Madras University, and MA in education, Algappa University, MS in general psychology, Madras University, MPhil education, and Algappa University, MA child care and education, Algappa University, and MA sociology, NMLI University. So, sir, have very huge educational background. Welcome, sir. And sir, apart from that, he published nearby 70 nursing textbook for the nursing and paramedical courses, including the Salt Cushion Papers, editor and national editor, board member for various national and international journals. And he published near the 60 scientific and research article in national and international journal, and 20 scientific and research paper presentation in national and international conference and workshop. And he organized state and national level geriatric health camps, eye donation, eye camps, blood donation camps, health awareness program, community development program, and national health activities. He guided various number of the students for the PhD and PG students in various Indian universities, and had professional membership in ENI, ISPN, CMAI, NRSI, Red Cross, St. John's.
Poonam ma'am?
Yes, sorry for the interruption. Maybe due to network error, na Surendra sir has left. So anyways, as our audience is well known to you, because we had you in previous sessions also. So with my heartfelt, I would like to express my gratitude towards Clement sir, as in spite of your busy schedule, you are providing your valuable time whenever we are asking from you, sir. And really hats off to your generosity. As you are a very known personality in the nursing profession, I must say that every one of us are very much known to you. And I would like to extend my heartfelt welcome to you for today's session. So without wasting much more time, we can continue with the session, sir.
Yes, madam. Good morning to one and all. And especially I thank the Nursing Teachers Association taking a great contribution to organizing sessions. Every day, one or the other topics, it will be discussed. Now the time for theory sessions is going on. Today we have reached into 9th session. I'm very happy, proud, thankful to Dr. Farooq Khan, his national president, and also Manish Kumar, secretary of Nursing Teachers Association, and also Poonam ma'am, and also the entire team of Nursing Teachers Association from national branch and the state branches, of all the leaders, legends, teachers who all are participated here in this webinar session. So today we have reached into the nursing theory session 9, and the previous speakers, they have discussed about the theory. You might have got some idea about the different types of theory and what is meaning of theory and what are the how to develop a theory and what are the importance of theory, what are the different types of theory you have learned. So I'm not going much discussing about this nursing theory, because nursing theory, as you know, that it is a principles, concepts, definitions, and these are interacting factors, interacting concept or interrelated with the theory. And theory is very important in our nursing, because theory is a backbone of our profession and theory needs to be developed. These are the perspectives of individual perspectives of the theorist. And there are many more theories has to come, especially in India. We need to come. There are more theories needs to come from India, because there are most of the theories, when we see, there are only the foreign theories, especially from USA, the all theorists are presented. And many more Indian theories should come and contribute their views, and they needs to be recognized globally. So I take an opportunity to thank everybody once again, and also say good morning to all the participants, maybe the staff nurses, maybe the teachers, and the nursing leaders, principals, and various institutions they are representing from themselves. So I'll go to the topic. So today we are going to discuss about two important theories. That is, one is helping art of clinical nursing theory. The second one is nursing becoming theory. Then helping art of clinical nursing theory by Ernst in Wedderburg. And the second theory is human becoming theory by the Rosemary Risa. And these are the two theorists, and we are going to discuss. So coming to the theory.
Excuse me, sir, please share the screen.
Screen, madam, not shared.
No, not shared, sir.
Madam, now?
Yes. Yes,
now?
Yes, it's okay, sir.
So coming to the first theory, Ernst in Wedderburg, that is helping out of clinical nursing theory, the word helping heart. The nurses are every day, they are contributing their service. It is a nursing is a heart and science, we used to say, and the helping heart, the nurse needs to understand the reality, and accordingly the clinical nursing care needs to be given. That's what the that is the concept of Wedinburg. So let us discuss one by one the history of Wedinburg. Ernestine Wedinburg was born in August 1900 in Hamburg, Germany. She has done her bachelor degree BA from Wellesley College in 1922, and then her RN, registered nursing, from John Hopkins School of Nursing 1925, and post graduation MA from Teachers College, Columbia University in 1934, and also certificate in nurse midwifery from the Maternity Center Association School for Nurse Midwife in New York 1946, and also the professional career. Wedinburg joined in Yale faculty in 1952 as an instructor in maternity nursing, and also associate professor of obstetric nursing in 1954 and an associate professor in 1956. She wrote a book on family-centered maternity nursing in the year 1958. She was influenced by Ida Rolando in her works on the framework, and she died in the year March 8th. This is a brief history of Wedinburg. And coming to the Wedinburg's concept and definitions, Wedinburg's defined the key terms commonly used in nursing practice. According to Wedinburg, these are the concept keywords she used in her theory: patient, need for help, nurse, knowledge, judgment, nursing skills. So these are the concepts discussed one by one. According to Wedinburg, her view of patient is any individual who is receiving help from some kind, be it care, instruction, or advice from a member of the health professional or from the worker in the field of health. Patient is any person who has entered the healthcare system and receiving a help from some kind, such as care, teaching, and advice. According to Wedinburg, the patient is one who is entering into the healthcare itself. She is considering as a patient. They may take a direct patient care or teaching or health education or advice from the health nurse or the healthcare worker. And the patient need not to be ill, need not to be sick, since someone receiving health-related education would qualify as a patient. So according to Wedinburg, so patient is said like that. And second key concept, need for help. According to this concept, the need for help is defined as any measures desired by the patient that has the potential to restore or extend the ability to cope up with the various life situations that affect health and wellness. It is a crucial to nursing profession that a need for help be based on the individual perceptions of his own situation. So Wedinburg has given importance for the individual perception to cope up with the illness or any discomfort situations. Third key term she used is nurse. Nurse is a functioning human being. Nurse not only acts but also thinks and feels as well. So nursing action is she provides the care based on the reality. Whatever the situation and the patient's symptoms, based on that, she understands and she give the care on the reality basis. And third term she used is knowledge. Knowledge encompasses of all that has been perceived and grasped by the human mind. Knowledge may be factual, speculative, or practical. Next key concept is judgment. The clinical judgment represents the nurse's likeliness to make sound decisions. The sound decisions are based on the differentiating fact from assumption and relating them to cause and effect. Coming to the nursing skills. Nursing skills are carried out to achieve the specific patient-centered purpose rather than completing the skill itself being the end of goal. These skills are made up of a variety of actions and characterized by harmony of movements, precision, and effective use of self. The sound judgment is a result of a disciplined function of mind and emotions that improves with the expanded knowledge and increased clarity of professional purpose. So totally according to the theorist view, Wedderburg explains that clinical judgment, it is very important. Clinical judgment, according to the reality, the judgment needs to be made. And the clinical judgment represents the nurse's likeliness to make the sound decision, which are based on the differentiating fact from assumptions and relating them to cause and effect. Means clinical judgment is very important to take a sound decisions. Sound judgment is the result of disciplined function of mind and emotions and improves with the expanded knowledge as well as increased clarity of professional purpose. In the theory, nursing skills are carried out in order to achieve the specific patient-centered purpose rather than completing of skills itself being the end of goal. Skills are made up of a variety of actions and are characterized by harmony movements, precision, and the effective use of self. In Wedderburg theory, self-awareness and self-discipline are the essential to personal integrity and self-worth. Whatever an individual does at any given moment is representative of the best judgment available for that person in that moment. And next one, coming to the elements of Wedderburg's theory. Wedderburg identifies there are main four elements in clinical nursing. They are philosophy, purpose, practice, and the heart. The philosophy. The nurse's philosophy is or her attitude and belief about life and how that attitude affected his or her reality. There are three essential components associated the nursing philosophy are. First one is reverence of life. Second one is respect for dignity and worth and autonomy. Third one is individuality of each human being and a resolution to act on personally and professionally held beliefs. Second element, purpose. The nurse's purpose is that which the nurse wants to accomplish through what he or she does. It is all the activities directed towards the overall good of the patient. Third one is practice. According to Wedderburg, the nursing practice, the practice of nursing is the observable action that are affected by the nurse's beliefs and feelings about meeting the patient's needs for help. Means the nurse needs to observe and based on the symptoms and the proper solutions and decisions needs to be made. Fourth element is art of nursing. The heart of nursing includes understanding the patient's needs and concern, developing goals and actions intended to enhance the patient's ability, and directing the activities related to the medical plan to improve the patient's conditions. Always the nurse also focuses on prevention of complications that can come up due to reoccurrence or the development of new concerns. Coming to the prescriptive theory based on three factors, according to Wedderburg's, main factors are involved in this theory. The central process, we are going to see the conceptual framework and application of the theory in next slides. The central process, which the nurse recognizes the essential to the particular discipline. The second perspective is prescription for the fulfillment of the central purpose. Third one is the realities in the immediate situation that influences the central purpose. So here, the central purpose is a nurse, one who is giving a care here, and the prescription, the intervention, what she does, and that everything should be on the reality basis. So here the process also, nursing practice and review and theory applications. So we are going to discuss later interpretation of application of clinical nursing based on the nursing practice and review. It's a valid outcome action, whether it is helped or goal is achieved, and the action, applying the knowledge, skills, and judgment according to the plan and needs. So here, this is one conceptual framework applied. The theory is applied on the research, and the central purpose is applied, means placed here. Application of knowledge regarding the osteoporosis to the woman in the rural area. And here, there is a researcher, the one who delivers the and recipient, and the goals and the means and the framework is given here. And the identification of pretest is given here based on the demographic variables, age, education, occupation, and marital status, religion, dietary pattern, and menstrual status, any other orthopedic diseases or problem, awareness about osteoporosis, and all this pretest conducted here, and administer of intervention, administration of planned teaching program to the experimental group on the osteoporosis among women residing in rural areas, and the validation post-test conducted here, and here the outcome of the study is adequate, inadequate, or adequate, and also the follow feedback is given here, and also the keys are given here. So like that, this theory, the central process, is applied on the reality in the research. And also the another one more model, one more conceptual framework. This is central purpose to assess the effectiveness of slow-paced breathing on pain perceptions during the first stage of labor among the primary gravida mother. And here the identifying the need for help, demographic variables are given here, and ministering the needed help here, the agent, recipient, goal, means, and framework is given here, and validating the data by a pretest and post-test, and the positive outcome, negative outcomes are measured here, and the feedback is going back. So this is a modified Ernst-Wedderburg's helping art of clinical nursing theory applied on the conceptual framework on research. The theoretical resources. Ida Rolando Palanter, understanding of use of self and the effect, the nurse thoughts and feelings as on the outcome of her actions. And Patricia James and William Dickoff identify the elements of prescriptive theory in Wedderburg's work, which she developed more fully in meeting the realities in clinical teaching. The primary concept when we are learning about the Weddenberg's theory, and it is very important that the nursing care has given in on reality basis in the clinical teaching. And the major assumption of this theory, relevance for the gift of life, and respective for the nurse needs to provide a care with dignity, worth, autonomy, and individuality of each human being. Resolution to act dynamically in relation to one's belief. And here, nursing process applications with the meta paradigms of person, health, and nursing environment, and also the key concepts are applied here. And these are the nursing meta paradigms applied to the particular theory. According to the person, maybe a nurse or a patient who is endowed with the unique potential to develop self-sustaining resources, and she has not clearly defined about health. And in nursing, is the practice of identifying the needs of patients through observation of symptoms, behavior of patients, finding what caused those symptoms, assessing if the patient is able to resolve the discomfort, and determining the need for help from the nurse or other healthcare team. In the environment, she explained about the policies, objectives, setting, atmosphere, time, human being, happenings, past, current, and anticipated, that are dynamic, unpredictable. And here, coming to the key concepts, there are four main concepts she applied here. One is philosophy, and second one is purpose, third one is nursing art, and the practice. We are going to discuss one by one. First one is person. Each person, whether nurse or patient, is endowed with the unique potential to develop self-sustaining resources. And people generally turn towards the independence and fulfillment of responsibilities. Each person is endowed with the unique potentials to develop self-sustaining resources. People generally turn towards independence and fulfillment of responsibilities. Self-awareness and self-acceptance are the essential to personal integrity and self-worth. Whatever an individual does at any given moment represents the best available judgment for that person at the time. According to health, means the second paradigm, health, she has not defined nor discussed in this model. Coming to the third component is environment. Weddenberg does not specifically address the concept of environment. She recognized the potential effects of the environment. Means she explained about the complications which arises from the environment. Third one is nursing. The art of nursing includes understanding the patient's needs and the concern, developing goals and actions intended to enhance the patient's ability, and directing the activities related to the medical plan to improve the patient's condition. Nursing as a practice of identifying the patient's needs for help through the observations of presenting behavior and symptoms, determining the ability of the patients to resolve the discomfort, or determining if the patient has need for help from the nurse or another healthcare professional. Concluding this Weddenberg's theory, nursing is the practice of identification of patients' need for help through observation of presenting behavior and symptoms. Second one is exploration of the meaning of those symptoms with the patient. Third one, determining the cause of discomfort. And fourth one, determining the patient's ability to resolve the discomfort, or if the patient has need for help from the nurse or other healthcare professionals. So concluding this, the first theory, Weddenberg's theory, the reality, the nurse needs to identify the symptoms, which is existing and present on the patients, on the basis of reality, she needs to make her decisions, and the appropriate care and care needs to be planned and implemented. Coming to the second theory, Rosemary Riza Price, that is human becoming theory. The man is a, according to this Rosemary, man is a unitary being in continuous mutual interaction with the environment. Man is a unitary being in continuous mutual interaction with the environment. The theory, the man is a combination of biological, psychological, social, and spiritual factor. This theory was originally presented by Rosemary, by a man living health theory, man living health theory. And the symbol of human becoming theory is based on this. The symbol of this theory is like this. And there are black and white, opposite paradox significant to ontology of human becoming. And green is hope. And also green and black swirls intertwining human universe co-creation as an ongoing process of becoming, and centrally it is joined. Centrally, this is joined, co-created mutual human resource process at the ontological level and nurse person process. And this is ontology is nothing but it is a study of existence. And there's a brief history about the Rosemary. Dr. Rosemary Riaz graduated from Defense University in Pittsburgh. She earned a master's and PhD through University of Pittsburgh. She became the Dean of Nursing School at Defense University in previous year, and the professor at Hunter College in New York between 1983 and 2006. Later, she became a professor at Loyola University, Chicago. She is the founder of current editor of Nursing Science Quarterly. She is a pioneer and changed her theory originally named Man Living Health Theory in 1981, and later it is changed into Theory of Human Becoming in the year 1992. She published 9 books and plenty of articles about the human becoming theory. She was awarded 2 prestigious Lifetime Achievement Awards, one from the Midwest Nursing Research Society and one from the Asian American Pacific Islander Nurses. In 2008, she received the New York Times Educator of the Year Award. She is a dedicated mentor and pioneer in student teaching and fellow colleagues, instructor, and speaking at numerous colleges and seminars. Race theory is an effort to enhance the quality of life. And according to Rosemary theory, that there are 3 principles are there. The first principle, one is structuring, meaning the imaging and valuing the languaging. Principle 2, configuring the rhythmical patterns is the revealing, concealing, and enabling limiting of connecting, separating. And principle 3, about the possibilities and powering and originating the transforming. And here you can see the first principle about imaging and viewing and languaging, and second principle about the Rosemary theory, revealing and concealing, enabling and limiting, and connecting and separating, powering and originating and transforming. and we are going to discuss in detail about the principles later in next slides. The meaning of this human becoming theory, the human becoming theory of nursing presents an alternative to both the conventional biomedical approach as well as the psychosocial spiritual approach of most other theories and models of nursing. This is human becoming theory guides the practice of nurses to focus on the quality of life as it is described and lived. Perez model rates the quality of life from each person's own perspective as the goal of practice of nursing. And also Rosemary first published the theory in 1981 as the Man Living Health Theory, and the name was changed into Human Becoming Theory in 1992. And this is the theory, framework of the theory. There's a meaning, there's a three main concepts out there: meaning, rhythmicity, and transcendence. And there's a freedom, paradox, mystery, and illuminability is there. So these are the components, and this is the structure what Rosemary has framed. And also this theory of human becoming has got there are three main elements. One is meaning, second one is rhythmicity, third one is transcendence. In meaning, there's a imaging, viewing, and languaging. And second element explains about the revealing, concealing, enabling, limiting, and connecting and separating. And also transcendence, discussing about the powering, originating, and transforming. Coming to the first element, that is meaning. Rosemary explains in the meaning, it is imaging of the person, valuing of the person, and languaging of the persons. She put it in a principle one, structuring meaning is the imaging and valuing of language. And rhythmicity, she explained the second principle by three components. One is revealing and concealing, enabling and limiting, and connecting and separating. And third one is transcendence. And according to that third principle, she applied in third element, that is transcendent, that is powering, originating, and transforming. And here, there is a theory. Rosemary's theory is explained, human becoming theory here. It is hands are joined together here. And the powering, rhythmicity, originating, revealing, and transcendence, connecting and separating. Valuing, enabling, limiting, and transforming, languaging, meaning. All the components are very essential according to the Rosemary's theory to becoming a human being. And the assumptions of human becoming theory, it makes the following assumptions about becoming. Becoming is a unitary with the human living health. Becoming is the rhythmicity of constituting the human universe process. Becoming is the human pattern of relating value priorities. And the fourth one is becoming is an intersubjective process of transcending with the possibilities. The fifth one is becoming is a unitary humans emerging. And first coming to the about the man, she explained Rosemary explained about the human is a coexisting while co-constituting the rhythmical patterns with the universe. The human is open, freely choosing meaning in situation and bearing responsibility for decisions. The human is unitary, continuously co-constituting patterns of relating. The human being is transcending multidimensionally with the possibilities. About becoming, the second part is becoming. Becoming is unitary human living health, and becoming is rhythmically co-constituting the human universe process. Becoming is a human's patterns of relating the value priorities. Becoming is an intersubjective process of transcending with the possibilities. Becoming is a unitary human emerging. And here she explained with the structuring meaning and also configuring the rhythmical pattern of relating and contranslating the possibilities she explained here. And structuring the meaning is imaging, value, reality, body language, languaging, personal realms of universe, reflective, conforming, not conforming, speaking, silence, moving, and stillness. So these are the structural meaning she provided according to the this theory, human becoming theory, and also configuring the rhythmical rhythms of relating is revealing, concealing, embedding, and limiting, and connecting, and separating. So these are the steps she has included here, and also contrasending with the possibilities of powering, transforming, familiar, unfamiliar, unique paths, and shifting the perspectives and pushing. So these are the methods she has used, applied here. Coming to the conceptual framework, and here in the center, she just applied the four elements here: care of the older person, and symptoms management, and the chronic disease, and the fourth element is workforce development. And here in next second round, she applied a person-centered care and knowledge translation, decision making, and patient safety and risk management. And the outermost in large level, she explained in a research perspectives of research, education, and practice. And nursing paradigms and the Rosemary's theory, according to her theory, person being who is more than and different from the sum of the parts, the environment, everything in the person and his experiences, and inseparable, the environment is inseparable and complementary to and evolving with it. And the third of nursing paradigm, she explains health like a open process of being and becoming, involves a synthesis of values. She explains nursing is a human science and heart that uses an abstract body of knowledge to serve people. The strengths of this Rosemary's theory, the first one is it differentiates nursing from other discipline practice, provides guidelines of care and useful administration. Third one is useful in education and provides research and methodologies. And the fifth strength is provides a framework to guide the inquiry of other theories, grief, hope, laughter, etc. The weakness of this theory, research considered to be in a closed circle, rarely quantifiable results, difficult to compare to other research studies, no control group, standardized questions, etc. The third weakness, it does not utilize the nursing process diagnosis. Fourth one is negates the negative idea that each person engages in the unique lived experience. And the fifth weakness, not accessible to the noise means the fresher nursing students or nurse, and not applicable to accurate emergent care. And the theory application in nursing practice, the first one is a transformative approach to all the levels of nursing. Second one is, this theory is different from the traditional nursing process, particularly in that it does not seek to fix problems. And third one is ability to see the patient's perspectives, nurses to be with the patient and guide them towards the desired health outcomes. The fourth application in nursing practice, the nurse-person relationship co-creates changing health pattern. And in the application to research, enhance the understanding of human lived experience, health, quality of life, quality of nursing practice. Second one, expands the theory of human becoming and builds a new nursing knowledge about the universal lived experiences, which may ultimately contribute to the health quality of life. So with that, I conclude this Rosemary's theory, which is human becoming theory. The human becoming a theory, it is mainly of three principles. That is, one is meaning. Meaning and rhythmicity and transcendence are the three important elements she used in her theory. And coming to the Wedderburg's theory, her concept, she prepared a model based on like this: central purpose in nursing, and the perception, prescription, that is given on the basis of reality. This is also called a prescriptive model. And these are the two theories or discussed. So with that, I'll just conclude myself. Thank you. Thank you for the organizers. Poonam ma'am, over to you.
Thank you very much, sir, for elaborated session. I'm audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Okay, sir. Sir, I can take the questions, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir, first question, that is what does it means becoming unitary with human living health?
Sir, one second, can you repeat? There's some disturbances here, sir. Actually, extremely sorry. There are some construction work is going on the other side.
Yes, sir.
So for me, it's a problem in hearing. Can you just
repeat the question? Yes, sir. What does it mean becoming unitary with human living and health?
Human?
Meaning human living.
Just health. 1 minute, I'll stop this so what can come, sir, for a while.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
One question is there. What does it mean becoming unitary with human living and health? So that we are composing in the human living health. Three components will be there. So that the mean they want to ask.
Human?
Living health.
Human living act.
Health.
Health. Human living health.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So. According to this theorist, sir, I just saying according to the theorist, Wedderburg's, you're asking about the Wedderburg's theory or you are asking about generally you are asking, sir?
That question is, sir, I think Wedderburg theory will be the Einstein Wedderburg theory.
Wedderburg theory?
Yes.
Just 1 minute, sir.
Clement, sir, you can open the QA box. In that you yes. can also see the question, sir.
Okay.
Q&A box.
There is a problem there in my system, madam. Actually, like it is not opening. It's immediately okay. got closed. Actually, only voice is audible. Okay, madam. This according to Wedderburg's theory, she used there are four elements, madam. She used philosophy, purpose, practice, and nursing act. So through nursing act, she wants to provide a nursing care on the reality basis. Means the nurse needs to understand the exact current problem of the patients, and she needs to analyze and she needs to study about the symptoms. Based on that, decisions needs to be taken, and also that decision needs to be, the nursing care needs to be implemented on the reality and existing conditions and existing need of the patients, sir. So the priority needs to be taken into account before giving a before implementing the care, and the reality needs to be understood, and what exactly the patient needs, and that care needs to be given according to the priority. That's what the theory says.
Okay, so the another question, how can we apply human becoming theory in practical setting?
Sir, human becoming theory, I just explained with one model here.
Yes, sir. So any example is there, sir? So
sir, examples.
Research study, any research study examples? For
sir, this human becoming a theory, we cannot, cause and effect cannot be measured in this. We can do it on the community setup, or we can do it in a clinical setup also. This theory can be applied. It is mainly to explain the, I'll just come to the theory, sir. Here there is a model given here, and the patients or the persons, here the care of the older person is in the center, and also symptom management and chronic diseases. And for example, we can take patients with cancer instead of older patients, patients with cancer, and the symptom management and the chronic diseases, what are the complaints the patients are getting it, and also workforce development. And this problem can be placed in the center, and based on that second round, the person centered care and knowledge translation and decision making and patient safety risk management are in the second level of studying, and the most outer frame, and we are studying about the research and education and practice. So these are the views. This is a simple model as given, and one particular disease condition I have not prepared actually.
Okay, so thank you, sir.
Yes,
another
sir.
Question is, sir, what are the factors hindering theory development in India?
What are the factors
hindering theory development in India?
1 minute.
Theory development.
Yes, sir.
Sir, what are the factors hindering theory development in India?
Theory development in India.
Yes.
Sir, first we need a motivation.
Yes,
and
sir.
Because so many theories which is from US and other part of the world, and Indian theories are not there. And for developing a theory, first we need to dream. Like what Abdul Kalam said, we need to dream bigger. Same like that, we need to apply in our nursing. There are so many things we need to bring the concept. What type of concept? For example, after that we need to come with a frame actually, and in that frame we need to include the four component: nursing and the four meta paradigm: person, environment, nursing, and health. These are the four paradigm. We need to put that concept up. So based on that, we need to explain. And next step, for developing this theory, we need to scientifically, through research, we need to prove the theory. And later on, it needs to be accepted by the professional body. It may be universally, it needs to be accepted by International Nursing Council. And then it needs to be published based on that. Before that, when the concept is, when we are preparing the concept, we need to, publication is very important based on that particular theory. So these are the different levels of process for developing the theory.
Thank you very much, sir. Sir, another question, that in which specialization that Ornstein-Widenbeck theory, in which specialization we can utilize? In which specific specialization? Pediatrics?
Sir, it is mostly clinically it is applied, sir. It is Widenbeck's theory. Yeah. Ornstein's Widenbeck theory. Yes, it is, sir, mostly applied in a clinical practice, but is very lessly applied by the students, nursing students and nursing practice. But it can be applied in clinical nursing practice. I have given an example in applying a mother with osteoporosis, and the second one is with the mother with primic rabida, and OBG application, and in two slides I have explained. So it is mainly applied on a clinical setting, sir.
All meds, sir, gynec, pediatric, we can apply it, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable answer.
I'm sorry for the question. It is happening nearby place, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Disturbing me and others, you all also.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So sorry for my side also, the technical issues in the virtual world. I'm giving the introduction, but in between that directly it will stop. So I can't able to communicate. So I think today's session is very informative and it will be most utilizable for all the nursing professionals. And a very big thanks goes to our speaker, Dr. I. Clement, sir, for the excellency and for the detailed presentation. It is very useful for all the nursing professionals. I think it's applicable for all the nursing professionals, and all students can also apply. The MSc nursing students, they also apply when they are going for the nursing practice. And we all are inspired by your great words, sir. And my, yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Okay. Once again,
thank you very much, sir.
This association, Farooq Khan, sir, Manish Kumar, sir, and Poonam, ma'am, and all the entire team for contributing this, organizing this wonderful conference, wonderful webinar, sir. Thank you once again.
Sir, my heartfelt thanks goes to the NTA organizing team, for giving me the opportunity as a moderator. And I'm also very thankful to our national NTA president, Dr. Farooq Khan, and Mr. Manish and Ms. Poonam Thakur, ma'am, for organizing this wonderful need-based webinar series. And my heartfelt thanks go to all the participants who are joining us for this session. And I think this presence is very important for us. And once again, thank you everyone for making this webinar session successful. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Okay, madam.
Thank you very much, Surendra sir, and Clement sir as well. I can understand the network glitches, but yes, then also ma'am, we are trying our best to provide the 100% of ours to our participants. And we are lucky enough that we are having the participants. They are very much cooperative and having patience as well. Because in this scenario, we can understand, because we are also discovering the new things. We are also trying. We are also experimenting, actually. And we are trying to modify if any error is occurring there. But anyway, Surendra sir, you did a well job. And Clement sir, I must say that as usual, as always, we are having you. We would like to listen from you every time. So we are lucky enough to have you every time. Whenever we asked, then sir is always agree. He said yes. So NTA team is really grateful to your efforts, sir. Thank you very much, Surendra sir, for a well-managed session. In spite of network glitches, you came again, you joined. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much, ma'am. You are managing the session in between. That's I understand.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Clement, sir. Have a good day.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, Poonam, participants, ma'am. See you tomorrow.
Okay, ma'am.